Hey guys, so in today's lecture we are going to see examples. So today we will see this example which was asked in GTU in 2011. So what is the question? So the question is, the electric motor is supported on a spring and a dashpot. So there is an electric motor which is supported by a spring and a dashpot. Now the spring has the stiffness. So spring stiffness is given. So I'll write given data. So spring stiffness K is equal to 6400 Newton per meter. And a dashpot offers a resistance of 500 Newton. So at 4 meter per second. So what it is given? So it is force and velocity is given. So it is it is damping coefficient is given, that is F by V. So it is 4500 divided by 4. So it is equal to 125 Newton second per meter. So damping coefficient is given. Now the unbalanced mass of 0.5 kg rotates at 50 mm radius. Now unbalanced mass is given for rotation, that is 0.5 kg, and radius is given, that is E is equal to 50 mm. So we'll just convert it into meter, 0.05 meter radius, and total mass of vibratory system is capital M, total mass is given, that is 20 kg. The rotor runs at 400 rpm. Now speed is given n, so we can find natural frequency with the help of speed 2 pi n by 60. So that is 2 pi by 60 into n. How much? 400 rpm is given. So our natural force frequency will be 41.88 radian per second. So now what we have to find? So first we have to find damping factor. So we have to find zeta. So what is the formula for zeta? That is C by CC. So do we have C? Yes. Do we have CC? No. So we have to find CC. So how we can find CC? So we know that CC by 2m is equal to omega n. So if we can find omega n, then we can find CC. Now do we have omega n? No. So we have to find omega n. What is the formula for omega n? Omega n is nothing but under root k by m. So do we have k? Yes. Do we have m? Yes. So both we have. So we can find natural frequency. So that is nothing but 6400 divided by 20 kg. So 00 cancel. So 320, root 320. So it is omega n is equal to 17.88 radian per second, and CC by 2m here. So CC will be equal to into 2 into m. So what is here? M is here total mass. So it is 17.88 into 2 into 20. So CC will be equal to the value of CC will be equal to here. This will be equal to 715.2. So this value we will put in this equation. So what is the value of C? So it is 125 divided by 715. So zeta will be equal to 0.175. So first question, the damping factor we have found. Now next question, amplitude of the vibration and phase angle. So we need to find amplitude and phase angle. So second question is, we need to find amplitude of the vibration x. So as this is rotating and reciprocating unbalance, so what will be the formula here for the amplitude? So the formula, first we will write magnification factor here, that is 1 minus r square whole square plus 2 zeta r whole square. This is the magnification factor. And now above we will write for rotating unbalance. So what it is, so it is nothing but, so our answer was here r square up into magnification factor. So this is magnification factor, and here it was small m, that is rotating unbalance m0 divided by capital M, that is total mass, into e. E is radius. So this is our formula. So before moving to this, we have all the terms. We have zeta, we have small m, we have capital M. But what is r? R is nothing but frequency ratio. So that is omega by omega n. So do we have omega and omega n? Yes. So omega is 41.88. So omega is 41.88, and omega n, how much is omega n? Omega n is 17.88. So it is 17.88. So whatever value we will get, we will put in this equation, and we will get amplitude x is equal to 1.5 mm. So this will be our answer. So we have found amplitude. So next, what we have to find, so we have found amplitude, and we also have to find phase angle. So we will use the formula for phase angle. So what is the formula for phase angle? So just the terms in the under root, that's its ratio. So that is tan inverse 2 zeta r divided by 1 minus r square. So just its ratio. So phi angle we will get is 169.41 degrees. So this will be our phase angle phi. Now next question is asked, the third question, that resonant speed and amplitude. So what is the resonant speed and amplitude? So what do you mean by resonant speed? So resonant speed means when omega is equal to omega. So at that time, what will be the value of n? So as we know that omega is equal to twice pi n by 60. So if the value of omega is changed to omega n, so what will be the value of speed n? So n, if we make the subject to it, so it will be omega n into 60 divided by 2 pi. So capital N is equal to 17.88 into 60 divided by 2 pi. So capital N will be equal to 170.82 rpm. So amplitude of resonance. Now next, what we have to find, amplitude. So resonance speed we have found, now we have to find amplitude for this resonance. So when resonance occurs, so r will be equal to 1, because what is r? R is omega by omega n, so both will be equal. So r will be equal to 1. So capital X is equal to, what is formula, m0e by capital M into r square divided by under root 1 minus r square whole square plus 2 zeta r. So now r is 1 here. So what would the formula will become? So m0e by m divided by, so here 1 minus 1, so this will be 0, and here 2 zeta r whole square and root, so root and whole square will cancel. So 2 zeta r, and r is 1, so we are left with here 2 zeta. So 2 zeta. So the amplitude will be equal to here 3.57 mm. So that is 3.57 mm. So this is the amplitude for when resonance occurs. So this is an example, very detailed example, asked in exam GTU for 7 marks. So many variables we have to find here. So we have to remember this equations in order to find the any variables. So now let's see in another example. So here, a seismic instrument. So what is a seismic instrument? So it is an instrument to detect the earthquakes with the help of vibration. So it is a seismic instrument is used to find the magnitude of vibration of a machine tool structure. So it gives a reading of relative displacement of 0.4 micrometer. So here displacement is given. So I will just list out the data. So displacement is given 0.4 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter. The natural frequency of the seismic instrument is 5 hertz. So FN is given 5 hertz. The machine tool structure is subjected to a kinematic excitation at a frequency of 2 hertz. So force frequency is given. So that is 2 hertz. So find the magnitude of acceleration of a vibrating machine and tool structure. So what we have to find? So we have to find the magnitude. So we have to find magnitude y of acceleration of the vibrating machine and tool structure. So we have to find y. So assume that damping of the seismic instrument is negligible. So there is no damping here. So what we will do here first? So first, these terms of frequency are given in linear frequency. So we'll convert it in angular frequency. So omega n is equal to 2 pi f. So it will be 2 pi into f. So that is 5. So it is 10 pi. So it is 31.41. Then omega will be equal to 2 pi into 2. So it will be 4 pi. So it will be equal to 12.56. So with the help of this, we can find the frequency ratio, that is omega by omega n. So frequency ratio will be equal to 0.4. So frequency ratio is equal to 0.4, because as you can see, so it is 4 pi and here it is 10 pi. So it is nothing but 4 by 10, so it is 0.4. so the steady state relative amplitude we have to find amplitude. So what is the formula for amplitude? So the formula for amplitude, z will be equal to z into y into r square divided by under root 1 minus r square whole square plus 2 zeta r whole square. Now here we have r, the value of r we have. So this all terms, magnification factor, we can find. Now the value of z is also given here. It is 0.4 into 10 to minus 6 meter. So we need to find y here. So if we put all the values here, so we will get y is equal to 13.26 mm. So what we have to find the acceleration of the vibrating machine also. So what is the acceleration of this vibrating machine? So we have found the amplitude. So find the magnitude of the acceleration of the vibrating machine. So acceleration is important. So acceleration of y will be equal to omega square y. So what is the value of omega square? That is 12.56 omega square into y is 13.26. so this value is 2.09 meter per second square. So this is the value of acceleration. So this is a simple question which was asked in GTU examination. And here one thing I forgot to mention here is that the value of zeta is not given here. Okay, so because we have assumed here given that as a damping of the seismic instrument is negligible, that is C is equal to 0, so zeta is C by CC. So zeta will be equal to 0, so this term will be cancelled out. So this term will be 0. So here root and square will get cancelled out. So we are left with here is y r square upon 1 minus r square only. So here the equation will become this only. So what the equation becomes, so that is z equal to y divided by 1 upon r square minus 1. So if you bring r square in denominator, it will be 1 upon r square minus 1. So this will be just and if you to find y, so we'll make subject. So y here, y will become, so we'll just erase and just write it again so you can understand. So after this, the y will become, that is z into 1 minus 1 upon r square minus 1. So if we put this values here, so we'll get y answer, that is 13.26 mm. So this type of questions are asked in GTU examination. So I hope you understood which two examples we have done today. So I will just repeat here. So this was a very lengthy example, first one. So damping factor was asked, so that is zeta is equal to c by cc. So cc we found from natural frequency omega n, and from that we found damping factor. Then for amplitude x, we found a frequency ratio, that is omega by omega n. And then for phase angle, that is tan inverse 2 zeta r upon 1 minus r square. So this is the both the examples which were asked in GTU. So let's I'm just giving an example for your practice. If you can solve by yourself, is an unsolved example. So that is a refrigerator weighing 30 kg. So mass is given, m is equal to 30 kg, is supported by 3 springs, each having stiffness k newton per meter. If the unit operates at 580 rpm, so n is given 580 rpm, find k if only 10% of the shaking force is transmitted to the supporting structure. Its transmission ratio is given, that is 10%, that is 0.1. so neglect the damping, so c is equal to 0, so zeta is equal to 0. So damping here we have to neglect. So what you have to do here, so here as zeta is equal to 0, so transmission ratio is given, so we can use direct transmission ratio formula, that is 1 upon 1 plus 2 zeta r whole square divided by under root 1 minus r square whole square plus 2 zeta r whole square. But here as zeta is equal to 0, so these terms will get cancelled out, so 1 plus 0 is 1. So transmission ratio will be nothing but 1 upon 1 minus r square. It is nothing but 1 upon 1 minus r square. But here we have, as we are taking under root, removing under root, so here we have to write plus or minus. So the sign will be plus or minus. So we have to find in both plus and minus. So transmitted ratio is given here 0.1. So this will be we can take any plus or minus here. So let me, so 1 upon 1 minus r square plus or minus r square. So what is r square? R square is nothing but frequency ratio, it is omega by omega n. So here we can find omega with the help of natural with the help of speed, it is 2 pi n by 60. So that is nothing but 60.73. and to find omega n, we need under root k by m. So do we have m? Yes, k we have to find. So if we can find omega, so in short, I am just keeping here 60.73 divided by omega n whole square. So omega n will get with the help of this equation. We have to take positive value here. So for answer, which positive value we are getting? It is 18.31 radian per second. So the omega k will be, omega n is equal to under root k by m. So what will the value of k? So the value of k here will be that is what I'm saying here, that there are three springs here. So there are total three springs. So we have to find for each spring. So we will just use here springs in parallel. So three springs equivalent will be 3k. So the value of k will be 3352.81 newton per meter. So I hope you understood this example. I will see few more examples and the last theory in the next lecture. So thank you very much.